I've really always wanted to record a cover version, something I've never done in my own name. And he said the song I want to do is The Great Pretender.
Hello, my name is Freddie Mercury, and this is my latest recording, The Great Pretender. I wanted to do a cover version, you know, a long time ago, and you can't do that with Queen, you know, because, I mean, we just write our own sort of original material, and I've always had that in the back of my head. And this song was the one I always wanted to do. The whole thing's brilliant fun. Well, over the top. Karina?
I think it's brilliant, and the video adds to it.
Yeah.
I'll give it 5.
It's one of the best videos ever. It's really good, very nice. Can we give it a take?
What I like about it is the way he's setting himself up. I think anyone who can rip off himself in that way deserves all the points. I give it 5.5.
So, well done to Fred. He wins this week's pop panel.
He thought it was appropriate because he was a pretender. He was certainly the great self-invention.
In Freddie, you had a shy person who lived with the protection of his persona.
Most of the stuff I do, it is pretending. It's like acting, you know. So you go on stage and I pretend to be a macho man and all that. And then in my videos, you know, you go through all the different characters and you're pretending anyway. So I think it's a great title for what I do, and it sort of suited to what I was doing. All this is pretense, and it's just fun.
If he was around today, people would be taking camera phone pictures of him, or there would be snapshots of him in Heat magazine. But Freddie Mercury was truly elusive and mysterious and enigmatic. We didn't know a lot about Freddie, and we still don't really know a lot about Freddie.
Why haven't you done any interviews in the past few years?
Because I hate them.
Why?
I just hate them. I hate talking to people I don't really know. Tiring on stage because of the way I come across on stage, and I'm very volatile, and that's the only part they see of me. I mean, I don't talk to everybody, so they don't really know the real me. And I don't think anybody will.
When we got to the end of The Great Pretender, I said, Fred, one thing we haven't thought about is a B-side. And he said, look, I'll tell you what, why don't you go and play some nice little classical thing on the piano? He said, I'll wobble over the top and we'll kind of think of something out. It became the B-side of The Great Pretender.
I was planning to do a solo project. And I wanted it to have some kind of bearing. Something different from another boring studio album.
I think now I have the time and the capacity to actually venture into areas which I would never dare. I don't want to end my life just being a rock and roll star.
It was 1986, just before Christmas, when Freddie got a call that Montserrat Caballé had heard him on an interview when they were in Spain on the tour.
You won't believe this, but
I went to the television and I was Freddy of all. And he says, what do you like more of Spain? And he was answering, Montserrat Caballé.
She's the best. That's what I listen to.
I love very much Freddy, but I was surprised he says that on television.
They said, you'd never guess it. I've had a phone call from Montserrat Caballé, and she wants to meet us. I suppose she wants to meet you. He said, no. He said, you're coming with me. We're going to Barcelona on Saturday. I think we ought to take something to play which might make her laugh, and she's going to cut the ice a little bit. He said, why don't we take this thing that we did?
We built a full concert PA system and we laid out a lunch so that we can have lunch together. The plan being that we all have a lovely lunch and then play her this song and say, this is the sort of thing we want to do.
I have never in my life seen Freddie so nervous. I mean, he was chain smoking. He was marching up and down.
We met here in the Hotel Ritz. He was a little shy in the beginning to sing with me.
He was so nervous that instead of saying, how lovely to meet you, would you like some lunch, and all the various plans that we had, and then he just blurted out, I've written a song for you, would you like to hear it?
But you sure you want to sing with me? And he says, yes, I was dreaming of that all my life. The only thing I asked him to have the score of Exercise in Philop. I said, give it to me the music, I will learn and maybe from that come something. But I was tricking him because I wanted to sing that as a vocalize in one of my recitals at the Royal Open House.
Well, Freddie didn't know. Freddie wasn't told about it. This was her idea. And Montserrat came on, but the normal pianist didn't. And Mike Moran walked on after her and sat at the piano. She then performed Exercises in Free Love.
And I was surprised of the big ovation. The public was crazy. I make them quiet and I say I'd like to present the componist, which is my woman and the headless is in the lodge, Freddie Mercury. So they begin to applause and he was very big impact for him. He says it's the first time that I received an ovation at the Royal Opera House.
Well, last night, I mean, she sang one of my songs at the Royal Opera House, so it's amazing. I mean, now I'm going to opera, forget rock and roll.
And we went after this to his home to have dinner. And so we begin to, after the dinner, to work. I said, well, this is very good because this is a crossover with feeling, not only with notes.
You're not tired now, huh? I'm going to rest a little.
I think rest.
Freddie was worried, oh, you're tired, you've got a flight at 9. You know, I don't want to be in trouble because you're late. And all. She said,
oh, you don't like me. You don't like my voice.
I sound so terrible.
You sound
no, I can sing too.
Well, everyone was surprised that we were in his home until 6 a.m. And they were asking what we have done. I said, well, we have done everything, but not what you thought.
She said things like, only one song, are you sure? You only want to do one song. And I said, well, let's see how we get on, you know, if you like more of my music.